Hello, everybody. This is Nick speaking. Welcome back to another episode of Polycraft. Today is episode... I don't know what episode number it is. I think it's like 58 or something like that, but... yeah, anyways, today you're back over here at the Water Temple, and... yeah... don't really have too much of a plan for today. Other recordings kind of got thrown off because my audio's deciding that it didn't want to record the yesterday at all for any videos because, well, Windows decided it needed to update and decided to make it so that nothing that I hear or say will actually show up on any recording whatsoever. I've actually fixed the problem now, and hello, slimes. How did you get in here? Not that I mind, I'll take your slime balls, but... okay, so there is apparently a slime chunk somewhere around here. And I'm taking a guess, since I was a medium guy, it's probably... well, actually, it could basically be anywhere because of how all this stuff is set up, but... anyways, I think the idea for today is going to be to come over here and use the shiny work pick to... basically actually get this room dug out, get a design going in here, because this is our cave spider farm, and, well, I want to, you know, actually have a nice spot to AFK for cave spiders. So basically the idea for today is to come over here and actually do this, and don't mind all the packed ice, I'm not actually using it for this, I just... you know, that's the extra supplies I have from over in the other stuff, so we're just gonna drop this stuff off. Also drop off the wood here, because I don't think I'm gonna use either one of them in this design. I think I actually want to do something a little more similar to the design we have over here at the AFK fish farm, which does rely a little bit on the dark oak, but it's mostly prismarine of the different styles, and I think that's gonna help a lot better here. And so basically what I want to do is I want to take these walls, we're gonna dig them one further back, except for like maybe like around here we're gonna put like the ring of the regular prismarine again, and or the dark prismarine I should say, not regular prismarine, because we know that's not what it is, so why am I saying that? And well, basically, I need to remember that this pick can break things really easily. And yeah, so basically the dark prismarine is going to come here. We're going to have a ring. Then I'm thinking I kind of want to do like panels with like maybe sugarcane in them. Do a ring, do another panel, do a ring. Yeah, and then we have this here, which is the lamp. So I'm thinking we'll have a ring here. If that's possible. Yeah, it looks like it will be. And then we'll need one in the middle. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, so maybe we have the ring here. One further over. Although that kind of messes with that. And then the actual switches on that ring too. The actual lamp is in the ring here, which makes things a little bit different, but I can always parallel by putting another lamp over here and kind of hiding that in, so can do that, and then we'll just do like one, actually be here, down the middle. And yes, our storage maintenance is literally right there, so yeah, it's a very interesting spot to work with, and I think I'm going to take some of this stuff out of my hotbar so I can put more blocks in. But yeah, basically, we're going to be taking this area and decorating it up. I do have some dark prismarine already, so yeah, what I'm thinking is I kind of want to just do something like this here in the corners. And actually, we can block that in there, too, and even you, too. Because we don't necessarily need those. So get like a ring and then get like another ring here. And then we'll get another ring like right here along the end. So we can take care of that, and maybe because we know we are gonna be doing like the whole redstone lamp thing here, maybe we can actually, now that I think about it, maybe we like put like a switch down here, and actually take the opportunity to put some like lamps. Yeah, I like that idea. We'll put lamps on all of the edges. So, lamp, let's see, do we have any lamps anywhere else? As you can tell, you can probably tell at this point, I really need to go through and organize things because we really have no like centralized storage system here in the water temple. It's just wherever I decide to throw things is where they're located. There's our sea lanterns. Yeah, since I have redstone lamps, though, I want to do redstone lamps. I don't think we have any more redstone lamps here. Nope, doesn't look like it. So, yeah, because this one is kind of necessary because it tells us when this is on or not. And we need to know when the farm is on. That is a very essential piece of this farm. So, you know what? Don't necessarily need it. We can do, we'll just do sea lanterns. And zombie? Zombie. I hear a zombie. I do. Where did you come from? Where did you come from? There's not a spawning space over here. There's probably a spawning space back here somewhere or something. Or he could have walked up from like down here or something, you know? Because there are. Oh, and that slime can jump high enough that he can hit me. Okay, interesting. So, yeah, I think I'm gonna actually do like. We'll dig this out. And actually, this is gonna go even one further back here. Because what I wanna do is I want to, like, get like a wall back here. And maybe we'll. No, we're not gonna put the sea lanterns there. What do we need? Silk touch, dude. Okay, we'll go grab the silk touch pick in over here. Silk touch, smoothest pick. There we go. Grab you, get back out. And we. I'm actually thinking we can like maybe put like the sea lanterns back in the back of wall here behind like this other stuff and then don't really have to worry about looking at it too much because it will be hidden. Yep, so I think that's kind of what I'm gonna do for this entrance area here is put sea lanterns. Kind of let this area fill itself out. Do another one back like this. Same thing again. And again, we'll kind of do something like that. Floor doesn't really. And then this one is going to be the weird one because we do have this other stuff going on in this area too. And yeah, cobblestone. You can go there. See, and then see, like, this corner is going to be kind of bizarre because we do need the lights there. We'll need lights here. And this is in the actual ring for the third ring. So that's going to be one of these interesting things we do have to work around, but I think it will be fine. We'll then take like some regular prismarine, go around the sea lanterns here. This is kind of going to be our background here. Which actually, I mean, it looks fine for a background block, I think. And we do need more of you because we do need to make some more of those blocks. And yes. They are very interesting blocks to make and craft. And there we go. Another 64 of them. I do like how they kind of all blend together pretty well here. And yeah, so gives us kind of our background here. And then what I really want to do is I want to take like this here, and I want to put like I was kind of thinking sugarcane, but I don't know how I pull that off very easily. Mean, I suppose dig this out, put the actual laying down where we want the sugarcane, and are you just a regular torch or are you a redstone torch? I have no idea. You're a regular torch. You can go into the sorting system. That. So let me grab you out of the basically the despawn trash can here, if it ever flows through. Did that actually flow into one of these or something? Because it should be over here by now. Yeah, because it's not a prismarine shard. What happened to that block? Really? What happened to my block? Well, that's a new one. Oh. That's not even the back. That's already the front part here. So it's in one of these chests. Yeah, those went right into here. Wow. Okay, I didn't even think about that, but yep, that's a thing. That's what these are here. Okay, so we can fill those in. That needs to be filled in as well. This can be a dark prismarine here because that's the aesthetic for the outside, and let me do you. There we go, get some of you there. Now, this is going to be the difficult one here because we need to make sure this redstone doesn't get like trounced with water or anything, and we also cannot do that in the meantime. So yeah, basically now bucket, fill with water, do things. Bucket, you. Hi. And you know what I'm thinking right now? I think I'm gonna take some time, fill this area in with water, get some sugarcane growing, and I'll be back. All right, so I technically never actually stopped recording. That entire thing was recorded, but I ended up knocking out the redstone a little bit. So we do have a few spiders collected here, so I'll just kill them because we can and take their juicy experience. But yeah, basically, at this point, we now have the dirt here. There's water behind all of it, so we basically have this stuff ready to go. And basically means that we now have a floor to put in, and kind of thinking that I want to do something interesting with the floor. I also want to do something interesting with this ceiling up here. I'm not sure how to go about this ceiling part of this because, well, we do have all this extra kind of weird sort of stuff going on in here, so. Yeah, it's basically. You know what? Why are we even using regular smooth stone? Let's just use you. And yeah, basically, at this point, we just need to, you know, fill in the gaps, get this kind of stuff ready to go because we need to basically put a ceiling on here and, well, there's not too many blocks we can use for the ceiling, which makes things kind of hard, and then kind of want to make this actually move upward a little bit. And also don't know why I keep switching back and forth between the picks, but I do. So yeah, basically, this tunnel, the ceiling, I'm thinking I kind of want to do the same sort of thing here. Do like the ring here. And maybe put some sea lanterns in the middle of this. And maybe even like up one further, just because that would then bring this tunnel up. But I know we don't have the room on the sides, which is why I didn't do it. And then maybe we take like this area up here and put some dark prismarine there. I like that. Do like that. Yes, that looks kind of cool. And of course we need a few more of them, so there we go. Have fun. Actually, you know what? Let's just craft a whole bunch of them. 8 of them. Sure, we'll use them for other spots. So there we go. So that kind of gets the ceiling done. We have the rings on the floor here, and I'm thinking, other than that, let's just do kind of some stone bricks down here. Will that look good, or I don't think that actually makes that much sense. Let's actually go back, because I know we have on the other room, we have like the dark oak floor. I think that makes more sense here to do some dark oak for floors. So that's what I'm going to do is dark oak. And yeah, I kind of see, seeing that part down below, I kind of like the aesthetic already of it. So yeah, I think that kind of gives kind of a cool little entrance way into this area. We do need sugarcane to go basically fill up both sides here, but we don't have any sugarcane over here. So we can't really do that just yet, but that's what I plan on doing. And let me get some crap out of my inventory here. There we go. So, yeah, I mean, that's kind of the entrance area. Now for the actual room, I mean, have it raised up on this half slab so I can kind of get in here and get these guys a little bit better, but I think I want to go upward with the ceiling in this room, especially considering this is kind of a larger room. And where did you come from? I guess there was just a guy hiding in there. So yeah, it does kind of take a little bit of a step up here, which is fine. And we do need to, you know, take some steps here and there so we can make things work. But yeah, I'm thinking we'll want to take this entire room upward. So let's dig out some more space above it for that. And thanks to nice beacon stuff, we can kind of not really have to worry too much about this taking a long time to do. And I am going to kind of keep this area down here kind of short, because we can, and it's kind of our little enchant area, so do like having the enchant area right next to this, but chances are I'm probably never going to do any actual enchanting over here. I'm probably always going to go to like the end farm to do it, or that this is more here so I can, you know, acquire levels to get mending stuff for mending stuff. So it's kind of the purpose of this area. And I'm actually even thinking, why don't me take this, why don't we just like take this, put you there, and put a sea lantern under the enchant table here. Or even. Ooh. Ooh, I have an idea. Let's put an obsidian under the enchant table. Make it look like it's just kind of propped up here. Yeah, I think and it's both dark enough that it looks like it's just one unit. I like that idea. Maybe we can even like take in these areas here that are the like the half, because the bookshelf is half a block as well, and make those bookshelves. Or we could, just like keep it kind of like that and leave a lip there too, which looks nice as well, but not the same sort of thing. Now, this corner over here is where you need a stand to do the AFKing. So, because the spawner's actually down over that way, and actually I think it's pretty much active in this entire area, but I'm kind of thinking that's probably the important side to stand on, so that's why I'm trying to kind of consider it as it's such, so that's the reason for that, and maybe we kind of let's frame this out next, I think would be the ideal solution to frame out the actual area over here. Maybe we like put like a sea lantern in. Maybe get like a get an interesting sort of design going on over here. And I'm thinking this can come backward. And maybe we do something like that, but of course we need more regular prismarine now, so jump down, grab regular prismarine. I'm gonna just keep running out of resources in this episode, aren't I? There we go. Yeah. I'm not very prepared here today, especially because this was kind of a last-minute thing, as I said at the beginning of the episode, just because other things decided that they wanted to crash on us, and well, there's only so much I can do to, try to alleviate the issues of all of this stuff. So, actually thinking maybe we take out these front blocks here and turn this into the regular prismarine too, just so we can maybe think about this is kind of our decorative entrance area to this. It kind of almost looks like it's like some sort of like centerpiece in this room. Maybe we like take this and continue it over the top of the room. Yeah, I think we dig this upward. And we mirror the actual design on the other side here, too. So, yeah, I okay, plug you, plug you. So that's going to be the height we're going to have this at. And then this will be prismarine blocks. And this one is going to be the sea lantern. Sea lantern. Boom. Nope, not you. You go there, you go there. And then basically I can put like a light there, and then we have like basically this kind of centerpiece in the room, and then we can have like the two sides over here, which are kind of the sort of larger areas that we'll just kind of use this as a background block in it. And then we have this over here to kind of design out. So, I'm I think I'm gonna take another little break here and get some more blocks crafted, get some blocks out of my hot bar, do that kind of stuff so we can, continue on with this project. So I will be back in just a little bit. All right, so I am back and yeah, oh, I missed a spot over here, but I did a little bit of work over here, and as you can tell, I kind of decided that, hey, this is kind of an interesting sort of area over here that we can't really do too much with, but I decided to put a bar across the top over here, and I kind of mimicked it on this side, and then we have some of these spots here again where we can put more sugarcane, and yeah, I suppose it kind of makes sense we have sugarcane in here just because this is the kind of experience area of the whole thing. And then I know, but we also have the library, which is down over here, which is where we actually took the enchant table from. Because, yeah. And then this can be like, maybe we can like put like a night, we can like store books in here, maybe do that kind of thing. Maybe put like a cow farm down here or something. Make this look like a cool sort of library area, and this is the area where we get all the enchanted books, but I think for right now, this area needs to be finished off. So, pretty simple. I'm just gonna kind of do that with the wall and say that that's the wall for that side, and I know it doesn't make too much sense, but it works, and we. Oh, please tell me I didn't just let water into all the redstone here. Oh gosh, no. Ooh-wee. That was a close call. Nope, we're good. We're good. No redstone was harmed in the making of this area. And then, yeah, just kind of come down here, put some prismarine brick in the bottom instead, and kind of highlight this area. Maybe even remove you for now. Change that also to a prismarine block. Put that back on. So that way we kind of get that little bit going. And well, the light here is in a kind of interesting position. We do need it to be next to this so we can have an indication of when the farm is actually on or off. And actually, when you're just like running in here like this, it actually makes a little more sense to do that, I think. And even now that I think about it, this arch around the outside makes little sense. So maybe we just kind of open. Yeah, we just kind of open it up like that. This will be kind of like an extra walkway. Yeah, that actually looks a lot better than what we had before, and I think it still fits with the area, and maybe that's what we do like on these areas instead of trying to incorporate all of this stuff in. Yeah, that makes a lot more sense, I think. But yeah, I know it's weird that I decided that this is gonna be kind of like a corridor. And yeah, I know it turned off for a moment, so hey spiders, you wanna come over here? Yep, thank you. You too. Dude, come over here. Thank you. And you're dead. So yeah. And then basically this kind of becomes a corridor. This will be our corridor to stay up here, and then this other one over here will probably be our entrance to the mine shaft. Because there is a mine shaft kind of, just down there, because that's where the spider spawner was. And I mean, even like getting into the spider spawner, it's like boop, boop. Right now it's just right here. And yeah, this is the mine shaft back here, of course, which, this is kind of in a weird spot, but over here is the actual mine shaft itself, which we want to link up and to everything, and well, it's not really linked up right now other than through that back road as far as I remember. Though maybe there is a link somewhere here, but I kind of forget where the link is, so... Oh yeah, up here... There's a link somewhere in here. To that, behind that other wall. But it's not that important right now, so... Because we can just kind of get in and out this way. It is a, like, very bad corridor to take through here, though. Especially since we're going through the maintenance area. And I don't like having to go through a maintenance area to get to a new spot, so... Yeah. Let's see. Did I close it off, actually? Maybe I closed it off. Maybe I closed it off. And of course we wouldn't know because it's probably behind the wall. Oh yeah, because it went down like over here. So there's like, yeah, another corridor over in here or something. But we kind of need to go up and over and then... You know, if we can go down in here and maybe make this like a... continuation of the water temple, that like, because we have all this area dug out for like different corridors and that, and I think just kind of making like a giant maze down here would be very cool to do. So so just one of these things, I just keep coming up with new plans and not really knowing how to implement them. So yeah, it's very interesting, and that's bugging me, so let's fix it. So, yeah. We did get the room design done over here today. I think the only thing left, I want to go grab a whole bunch of sugarcane so I can basically fill in all these panels. So, I think I'm gonna run over, hopefully, Dino Land, if those are still operational. And see if maybe we can get some sugarcane from the farm over there. Because, yeah, sugarcane is not one of our very good farms that we have right now. And I find that the automatic farms for sugarcane actually don't work all that great. Because, yes, at least the one I have in the world... seems to break all the time because of the loading and unloading of the chunks. I mean, even like... Oh, I have those blocks in my ender chest. Whoops! Yeah, so... Let's see... Where would I have put sugarcane? Is it in miscellaneous? Nope. Sugarcane. If I even have a sugarcane chest. Oh, I probably don't even have a sugarcane chest, do I? Okay, well, there's some in the flower chest. Okay, we have no sugarcane. That's kind of what I figured, but, you know, doesn't hurt to check. Yeah, see? See, this thing's always, like, stuck out every time you come over here to reload it. But, well, we do have a little bit of sugar cane here, so... There we go. At least grab the little bit we have. And that's... It should be a good amount. Alright, so we are back, and I basically have the room finished. I think I'm going to actually keep this as oak, because it doesn't make this look kind of important, and points out that, hey, this is not water, this is not part of the path, this is something else, so I think that is important to keep, but yeah, sugarcane is starting to grow in. We are getting some of these too tall now, and yeah, basically the idea is they're all gonna grow to 3 tall. This entire area is gonna be filled with the sugarcane, so it's kinda gonna fill that area up, and basically it's going to be kind of like a manual-ish farm if we ever like need a whole bunch of sugarcane for anything. So that's kind of the reason why I decided that, hey, let's put in these sugarcane panels in this area. So they're here, and then I'm thinking this tunnel will go down this way, and we can like put like maybe some farms off to both sides, like cow farm for sure, maybe other kinds of animals too, maybe like, I don't know, maybe rabbits or something, so we can try to get breed for like rabbit's feet for leaping potions or something, I don't know. Do something different and interesting with it. So yeah, that's kind of where we are right now, and this style looks a lot nicer. I think the dark wood and the dark prismarine goes very well together. In here, I mean, since I don't have so much of the dark prismarine, I don't know that it goes as well in here. I mean, maybe we changed this stuff out for dark, and that would basically lift this area up, or maybe even like put a st these as stripes of dark rather than just regular prismarine. But I mean, it still looks fairly decent with this stuff, but I think just having this kind of all like this, it looks very well done, and I do really enjoy what I was accomplished here today. So unfortunately though, it looks like we need to remove this crafting bench and then say that this is probably gonna be the end of the episode here, 'cause can't imagine that we would be able to get much else done here. Maybe this needs to be one more prismarine block, and we can do that pretty easily. We just need a few shards here. And yeah, I basically took most of them, and they are all blocks now in this new build. So yeah. And I'm thinking if we do that, then we kind of make this look kind of like it's almost a panel, I suppose, is kind of what I was thinking this would do, but maybe not. And this being over here, kind of like, yeah, it's obviously this side and this side are very different as how they line up and all that. So, because where this tunnel has to be located, I mean, I could have told this room to be like over this way a little bit, but then I think I'm running into where this tunnel will have to go. So, which this tunnel actually goes out for a little ways, and then it, you know, kind of goes down, because that's basically down that way. This one is to the mine shaft currently, which means that we need to basically make way for that all to happen, and also pick up our junk out of this chest now that we dropped it in there. And of course, junk's gonna be in this one too, just because of where all the hoppers and stuff are located. So basically, that actually kind of wraps up this episode. I know it's a kind of rushed, shorter one, but it's more or less I either rushed this episode or don't put out an episode at all because, well, I didn't really have that much of a choice, and I'm just now realizing over here we don't have enough light. You know what? Light. Let there be light. There we go. Okay. Yeah, that's gonna probably bug me at some point, but you know, there's not really much of a spot that we can do over here, and it's not like we can put a panel over here or anything either. So yeah, I think the tunnel design here worked out well, and then the room also works out pretty well. I'm not sure though. I kind of want to do a stripe of dark prismarine. I really want to do a stripe of dark prismarine. Hold on. Hold on 1 minute. Dark prismarine, we are testing you in the room. I'm thinking maybe like this middle row here. We just turn this from like a regular prismarine into dark prismarine. Yes, that definitely. I like that. Oh, whoa. No. Bad. Bad. And somehow that didn't even knock out the. Wow, okay, that's cool. That doesn't knock out sugarcane. Oh yeah, I suppose that makes sense. Now that I think about it, that it wouldn't do that, but. And. Yes, that's those stripes definitely lift up this design a lot. Yeah. Yeah, just kind of add a little bit of an accent to this area and. Mean, if I could. I don't think putting it across the floor would look good though in this area, so I'm not gonna do that, and I'm not going to try to make this area something it's not supposed to be, so. I do think though that this is going to be the end of the episode, or. Yeah, I don't know why there would be anything else, because. I didn't really plan anything today, because no time to plan, just need to record. So, yeah, let's take our time, finish up those last few blocks, and I think I'm gonna call this an episode. Thank you all for watching, and if I can, there we go. Make some blocks here. That's not gonna be enough blocks. Okay, I want to do the outro correctly after I'm done with everything. Okay, so thank you all for watching, and I will see you next time. Bye!